Good morning, everybody. I got a question for you. Have you ever been misunderstood by someone you love? Have you ever unintentionally hurt someone that you're close to? Have your motives ever been questioned by someone with whom you really long for a close relationship? Well, everybody has that happen to them from time to time. What do? Do we get mad and kind of isolate and not want to talk to that person, get mad at them because they're misunderstanding us? Well, of course, there's a healthier thing to do, and that is to contact that person and try to clear up the misunderstanding. And that's what Paul does in 2 Corinthians chapters 2 and 3. We kind of flew over these chapters this last weekend and went from chapter 1 to chapter 4, but there's some instructive stuff that happens in chapters 2 and 3. Really, it starts at the end of chapter 1. The Apostle Paul has been misunderstood by the Corinthians. They think he's unreliable because he promised to visit them and then he didn't. They think he's overly harsh because his letters are, they think, critical of them, and so they think he doesn't love them. And so Paul has some relational tension here that he's got to deal with. And that's what he does in chapters 2 and 3. For example, at the end of chapter 1, he says, "Listen, I planned to visit you on my way to Macedonia and again on my way back because I wanted to get help from you for the poor people in Judea." He says, "Do you think I made these plans without really meaning it?" In other words, he's clearing up the fact that he didn't visit them as promised for reasons that were sort of out of his control. Stuff comes up. And then he goes on in chapter 2, verse 4, he says, "I don't write to make you sad, but to let you know how much I love you." And then in chapter 3, verse 1, he says, "Do we need, like some people, letters of recommendation to you or from you? You yourselves are our letter, written on our hearts, known and read by everyone." In other words, he's saying to these Corinthians who were far from perfect, "You are our letter of recommendation." When people see what has happened in your hearts, in your lives. So we see here Paul is clearing up this misunderstanding by basically saying three things. "I'm sorry, I love you, and I'm on your side." So here's my question for you. Are there people in your life right now to whom you need to say, "I'm sorry, I love you, I'm on your side"? Do it now. Contact those people. But then second, I want to ask you, are there people in your life for whom you are their letter of recommendation, mentors who have really changed your life? Well, I would say contact that person and say, "Thank you for your impact on my life. I really love you." In other words, who do you need to contact in order to reconcile? And who do you need to contact in order to honor? I would encourage you to do that today and follow the example of the Apostle Paul in these very relational two chapters of 2 Corinthians. Well, God bless you. You do that, and I know you are going to have an even better day.